Welcome to the Daily Forkast, July 26th, 2021. I'm Angie Lau, Editor-in-Chief of Forkast News, covering all things blockchain. Coming up, China's Bitmining doubles down on its overseas mining business. Korean crypto exchange Upbit accused of illegal transactions. And Ethereum's creator joins the cast of animated crypto series Stoner Cats. Let's get you up to speed from Asia to the world. First up, one Chinese company has decided it is more likely to make a fortune mining Bitcoin than by winning the lottery. China-based Bitmining, which was formerly known as 500.com, says it has exited the lottery-related business that it started out in to focus on its overseas mining business instead. Turns out mining Bitcoin is a little bit more lucrative. Bitmining's Chinese lottery-related business apparently lost 9.8 million renminbi, or around 1.5 million US dollars, in the first quarter of 2021. And the company says that due to the continuing losses there, it will now dispose of it entirely. The closure is not expected to have an impact on Bitmining's financial position. Now, the New York Stock Exchange-listed company began its pivot towards crypto mining in December of last year as Bitcoin prices boomed. And as part of that strategy, it acquired Bitdeer's mining pool business, BTC.com, earlier this year. Meanwhile, a Korean lawmaker is accusing one of its own major crypto exchanges for behaving badly, engaging in illegal foreign exchange transactions. Lawmaker No Wung Ray claimed Upbit may have illegally circulated funds overseas using its affiliated companies in Singapore and Indonesia. No says that those affiliates are non-operating paper companies and that the police will soon begin an investigation. Upbit has denied all of the accusations. It's a uniquely Korean conundrum, though. According to Korean customs figures that were cited by the lawmaker, almost $1 billion of illegal foreign transactions took place in the first half of this year. 70% of that used virtual assets to do so. While Upbit fights this specific allegation, one expert told Forkast News that Upbit's case may not be an isolated one.
업비트가 1조가 넘는 환치기를 했다 그러면 다른 데도 당연히 했을 겁니다. 더 불법적인 것에 가담했을 것이고 아마 그것이 수사가 더 진행된다 그러면 잡아낼 것이다. 그러면 모든 거래소에 대해서도 좀 처벌을 할 것이다.
Kim says although strict new crypto regulations are not fully in place until September 24th, illegal foreign transactions using crypto can still be punished using the existing law. All right, on to the markets now. The first day of the Asian trading week, Bitcoin up almost 10% at just over 38,000 US dollars. This on a mixed Asian trading day as Sino-US relations appear deadlocked. That's the word used by China's vice foreign minister as talks with his US counterpart began. The first between both countries since March. That's as of 4 p.m. local Hong Kong time today. And in the top 10 for cryptocurrencies, Dogecoin and Cardano both up just over 9%. Cardano reportedly on the list of cryptos that Amazon is considering to accept payment after Bitcoin, according to an Amazon insider in a report by UK paper City AM. And finally today, for those not fully sure how cryptocurrency works, well, a cartoon cat could be set to help. You heard me right. Stoner Cats is an animated web series where five cats get advice from their taxidermied friend, Katsington. And Hollywood A-listers Mila Kunis, who's producing the series, and her husband Ashton Kutcher, who features alongside her as the voices of two of the cats, have recruited a new best friend, you could say, to play the role.
Hey, babe.
Yeah?
What's Ethereum?
So Ethereum is a general-purpose blockchain.
Yep, that's Vitalik Buterin just hanging out in their kitchen explaining what Ethereum is. The series aims to teach people more about the world of crypto via names and voices they recognize and trust. The cast will all be paid in Ethereum, by the way, and if you want to watch, you'll need to buy an NFT via their crowdfunding campaign. So you got cats, NFTs, and Hollywood. A powerful crypto combo for the 21st century. And that is the Daily Forkast from our vantage point right here in Asia. For more, visit forkast.news. I'm Editor-in-Chief Angie Lau. Until the next time.